Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about Bitwarden's password manager, and in particular, how to secure it with second-factor authentication. So let's get started. If you're not familiar with Bitwarden, I encourage you to watch our previous videos. One's an intro video, the other one is a deep dive into organizational accounts. Bitwarden is a fantastic capability that enhances your online security. First thing you want to do is get an account, and after you have established an account, you want to log in, type in your email address, your password, and log in to Bitwarden on the browser. The next thing we'll do is we'll go over here to settings. We'll click settings and then come over here to the left and go down to two-step login. Select the two-step login. And the first one we're going to do is manage the authentication app. And before we get into actually implementing the authentication app, I wanted to bring up Google Authenticator, Microsoft Authenticator, and Yubico Authenticator. I want to go over the differences in the way that these authenticator applications provide you time-based one-time passcodes. If you see over here on Google Authenticator and Microsoft Authenticator, when you bring up the account, they automatically have the accounts listed on the application. When you bring up the Yubico Authenticator, there are no accounts. The reason is because the accounts are stored on the hardware security key. So until you plug in your key, there are no accounts registered with the authenticator. The benefit of that is if you lost your device and still had your key, you would still be able to authenticate to the application no matter where you were at. So in essence, if you have the key, whether you're on your desktop or on your mobile phone, wherever you plug it in and there is a YubiKey application, you will have access to your accounts. Now, I run Windows 10, Windows 11, and Google Authenticator is not available on that platform. Microsoft Authenticator is not available, surprisingly, on its own operating system. So it only runs on, I believe, iOS and Android, and it's same thing for the Google Authenticator. So if you want something that is more cross-platform available, by far and away, Yubico Authenticator is the best alternative. The benefit of Google Authenticator and Microsoft Authenticator versus Yubico Authenticator is the fact that you only need one device. Whatever device you've installed on, in this case in the phone, you don't have to have a separate entity like a hardware security key. So there's pros and cons of these. I just wanted to quickly go over the differences. They all provide the time-based one-time passcodes. It's just a matter of what you're most comfortable with. If you want more information on YubiKey and the implementation and configuration of it, click on the video playlist above. We've covered it in depth in a lot of different scenarios. I think you will find those useful. Okay, moving on to implementing this on the Authenticator app, we're going to use the Microsoft Authenticator for this implementation on Bitwarden Password Manager. So the first thing you're going to do is type in your password after you've clicked on the Authenticator app section, and you're going to click Continue. Now, what comes up is what they call a QR code and a hardware, well, it's not really hardware, it's really a software security key here at the bottom. Now, I agree with security organizations and security professionals that are recommending people take advantage of these authentication methods. I am a little dismayed with the lack of emphasis on what happens when things go wrong. So let's say you use a phone and you authenticate this through the QR code, and then you lose your phone, and now you want to authenticate to your application. You can't do it because you've lost the ability to do that. But if you copy this key and you store it in a secure encrypted file or print it out on a piece of paper and then put it in a safe, if you lost the device that you authenticated to, then you would still be able to reconstitute your capability to authenticate to your accounts. Okay, so we'll bring up Microsoft Authenticator. and we'll click on the three dots here. And we've done a couple videos on how to secure Outlook with the Authenticator app. If you're interested in that, I highly recommend that you click on the link above. So we'll click on the three dots. We'll say add an account, and it's going to be a personal account. And then we come over here and we select scan QR code. Now what's going to happen when we click this scan QR code is it's going to launch the camera app on your phone. So make sure you have the rights and privileges for the application to use your camera. And then you're going to take that and scan this QR code, and then it's going to register that account over on the Microsoft Authentication application. So we'll click scan QR code. And at this point, you're scanning it with the camera app. And once that is scanned, you will see that account is now linked to the Authentication app. But we're not done yet, because what we have to do is now link the Authentication app back to Bitwarden. Bitwarden needs to certify that everything went fine. So in order to do that, you will click here and you will take this one-time passcode and you will put it into here where it says enter resulting six-digit verification code for the app. So we put that code in here and then we will select enable. And now you can see two-step login authentication app is enabled. But that authentication is only on that Microsoft authentication app on that particular device. If you want to put it on another device, you have to copy this seed key and make sure that you can put that seed key into another authentication application or another device. Okay, so we close that and we're going to go into the Yubico YubiKey OTP security key. So we click that. Once we click that, you'll be prompted for your master password. You type in your master password and click continue. Then we'll scroll down here so we can see everything. And you see there's five key slots available for the YubiKey. There's one key slot available because I have four keys registered. So what we're going to do is physically plug in a hardware security key to the computing device, and then we'll physically touch that computing key, and it will register that key over here with the Bitwarden application. Now, what's pictured here is a hardware security key. They call it the blue security key from Yubico. This key is not compatible with this YubiKey section in Bitwarden. Also, the blue security key is not compatible with the Yubico Authenticator application. The blue security key is compatible with the WebAuth section of Bitwarden, and we'll explain that a little bit later in the video. It is a little confusing, but that's the way it's set up. If you have a time-based one-time passcode compatible key, that can be set up in this section of Bitwarden. So having said that, you'll come down here and you'll select this box. You'll key press the key, and then it will update the key and show you that YubiKeys are updated. So we've added this particular key. Now, if you notice, this key's characters that are visible here on the screen are the same as this, because it was the same key that I had previously added. What's interesting to note is the first 12 characters are considered to be a public ID for OTP. So right here it says that public ID of the YubiKey device itself is the first 12 characters. All right, so we'll close that. Now we're going to go into the WebAuth section. You see right here it says FIDO 2 WebAuth. So it'll ask for your password. Click continue. And you can have up to five keys in this section of Bitwarden. So the first thing you want to do is click on the name box. Then type in the name of the key that you want to label the key. And then come down and read the key. Then type in the PIN of the key. And then at the bottom here, you can click Save. And now you can see this blue security key. That's the one I was talking about previously that was not compatible with the Yubico OTP section is compatible with the WebAuth section. Okay. And we come down here to close and close that section out. Now I want to show you what it's going to look like once you add the WebAuth section in for logging in to Bitwarden. So when you log in to Bitwarden, when the WebAuth is active, you have a key in one of the key slots, it's going to come up here with a FIDO2 WebAuth screen and say touch your key. Now what we're going to do is just cancel this, because let's say for some reason you didn't want to use FIDO2 and you wanted to use one of the keys that you had put in the YubiKey slot for some reason. What you would have to do is cancel this. And then on the next screen it says verify your identity, cancel again. You're going to come down here and highlight the use another two-step login method and click that. Now your other authentication methods, Authenticator app, Yubico, will also appear. And now you can select the Yubico OTP security key section, and you can key press that and click continue. And there you go. That concludes the video demonstration of adding 2FA to Bitwarden. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. I hope you will consider subscribing, and have a great and wonderful hack-free day.